Welcome back to the Science Kid News. Today we're going to go look at where the new words come from. So hope you enjoy. New words come from by borrowing. Like for example, Rome and France brought legal and religious concepts like auto and jewelry. But trade brought crops and cuisine like Arabic coffee, Italian spaghetti, and Indian curry. Well, there's another one is called clone. There's a word that is very old, but it describes a new one. Like clone, it is a small twig from the old. We grow and call clone. That's a new one. Second, new words come from combining. We combine two whole words like airport or starfish, but they take parts of the words to combine, like internet, branch, or spork. But the last one is adopting. For example, two words like villain. Just is when the old, it's just a peasant farmer, although it's just a farmer that digs holes and they plant seeds. But when right now, it turns out to be a bad person from the film of Pirates, right? Well, next word is geek. Geek when the past, it's just a carnival performer. But then, it turns out to be a strange person. But now, it turns out to be an awkward genius. So now, I have a conclusion for you. Some words don't stay as long as you think. Some words can stay long, like it's also in some apps, like TikToks, Facebooks, and only on YouTube too. There's a lot of words now. But some words adapt to changing times, like mostly in historical themes, historical music, or even historic stories. But probably it's happening in right now. And some words die off because those words don't use it so much, so they don't exist in our world, so there's never been that word again. So that's all of the news what I talked today, and see you next time.